Welcome back. In the last video, we have seen what is carbon nanotube. I will just revise the points. Graphene, it is one atom thick layer of carbon interconnected into hexagons. And rolled up sheet of graphene is called as carbon nanotube. Okay. Based on rolling, there are three types that also we have discussed in the last video. One is armchair. That is hexagons, they form a line parallel to axis. Second is zigzag, the hexagons form a circle around the axis. And third is chiral, there is no definite pattern. Okay. Again, there are two different types of carbon nanotubes, that is single walled carbon nanotube and multi walled carbon nanotube. Okay. So in this video, we will discuss different properties of carbon nanotube and their applications. Okay. So first we will discuss different properties of carbon nanotube. Okay. So first, mechanical properties. Now we know that carbon nanotube is single large molecule made up of millions of carbon atoms and they are connected by covalent bond. Now, we know that if we have one molecule, it is very difficult to dissociate the molecules or separate the atoms of the molecules. It requires high energy. Okay. And therefore, obviously, carbon nanotube is very strong with very high tensile strength. Okay. Its Young's modulus is 5 times that of steel. And the second peculiarity, it can be bent like rubber. Okay, so this is very important quality we have. At the same time, it is very strong with high tensile strength and it can be bent like rubber. So these two properties we get together. Okay. Thermal conductivity of carbon nanotube is very high. Now these carbon atoms in the tube are connected by covalent bond. So when heat is given to one end of the tube, then these covalent bonds, they start vibrations. And through these vibrations, the heat is carried to the other end of the tube. Okay, so therefore, thermal conductivity of carbon nanotube is very good. Next property is the electrical property. Now, electrical conductivity based on orientation of carbon nanotube. Now, if it is armchair configuration, if we have the armchair carbon nanotube, it is very strong conductor of electricity. It is very good conductor. Its conductivity is even better than copper. And if we consider the zigzag and chiral orientations, they show semiconducting properties. Okay. Now, remember, armchair is very good conductor and zigzag and chiral are semiconducting in nature. And if some foreign molecule or atom is attached to the carbon nanotube or carbon atom in the carbon nanotube, there is change in electrical resistance of that tube. Okay. Now, next property is chemical property. Now, in the properties of nanomaterials, in one of the video, we have seen that the surface to volume ratio is high. So, nanoparticles, they share very high surface area and therefore their chemical reactivity is better. The same thing is here, the carbon nanotubes, their diameter is very small but their surface area is large and therefore they show increased reactivity. Okay. So, these are about the properties of carbon nanotube. Okay. Now, we study different applications of carbon nanotube. Now, it has many applications in biomedical field or in biotechnology. Okay. In biomimetic composite, CNT is used as a fundamental unit. So, one example I will give you. Now, suppose any person is having the bone defect or bone disease due to osteoporosis or sport injury or like that. Then many times we require bone implant. And we know today's whatever bone implant we are using, it has many problems with it. But if we use carbon nanotube, it is very strong, we know. Its strength is very high. So we can use the composite which contains carbon nanotube. We can think of it for bone implant. Okay, see, this is just one example I gave you, but there are many applications in biomedical. Okay, second application, again in again it is medical application, that is in the treatment of cancer. These carbon nanotubes are inserted among the around the cancerous cells, and they are excited using radiowaves, and when they are excited, they kill the surrounding cancerous cells. So it is used in the treatment of cancer. Next, in electrical engineering or electrical circuit, we know armchair is very good conductor, and zigzag and chiral, they are semiconducting. So the semiconducting nature carbon nanotubes, they can be used in field effect transistor. Armchair, it is very good conductivity, so we can use it in the spacecraft or aeroplane, because we know spacecraft, aeroplane, they are weight sensitive. Weight sensitive because they are working against, we have to lift spacecraft against gravity. So to lift it, we require huge energy. So if we use or if the body of the spacecraft is made up of CNT, it becomes lightweight, and obviously it requires less energy. This is the one advantage. And in the spacecraft, again we require integrated circuit. So in the integrated circuit in the spacecraft, if we use armchair CNT, it helps us to reduce the energy or energy consumption, or save the energy. Okay, electric bulb made up of CNTs, they can be switched on instantly, they can be dimmed easily, means whatever power we require, whatever intensity we require, either we increase the intensity or decrease the intensity as per our requirement. So it is very easy to operate, and it also helps to save the energy. And secondly, it do not contain toxic mercury vapor, that is the advantage from environmental point of view. Okay, it can be used in sensor, because if some foreign molecule or foreign atom is attached to the carbon nanotube, there is change in the resistance of the carbon nanotube, so it can be used as a sensor to detect carbon monoxide or other biological molecules. Okay, next application is in paper battery. So here we use a very thin sheet of cellulose. Now we know in the battery we have electrolyte and electrode. So this thin sheet of cellulose, it acts as electrolyte. And in this thin sheet, there are carbon nanotubes. It is infused with the carbon nanotubes. These carbon nanotubes, they act as electrode, and thus it allows the battery to conduct the electricity. It is a tube-like structure, so we can say it is a tube or it is a capillary, so it can be used to store hydrogen. And again, we use the semiconducting nature of carbon nanotube to develop the solar cell. So if we use carbon nanotube in solar cell, so it can absorb UV, it can absorb visible and even infrared region radiations, and there it can absorb all these three radiations. So therefore, efficiency of this solar cell is very high. Okay, so these are the properties of carbon nanotube and applications of carbon nanotube. Okay, so in this video we have studied different properties and applications of carbon nanotube. So okay friends, so here we complete the unit nanotechnology. Okay, thank you very much.